to change gears a little bit, just a little bit, because this channel, I'm also trying to create a new way of, I mean, a kind of new base of my channel, because so far the channel was all about biomathematics. So I did a postdoc recently that I was able to participate from a startup, the Applied System Biology, and I was able to design a web application and so on. So my question is, suppose that you have a very good model, suppose that your model for system biology work, suppose that system biology, your model for system biology is approved, this process of transform your model innovation, such as you build a software that you are able to deliver to the society. Maybe can you talk a little about the difficulty of innovating biomathematics, creating models for software, for the society, the challenge of the industry, and so on? I mean, if you understood the question, I don't know if I was a little bit out of a little bit all over the place.
No, I understand you, and I think it's really a very important point, because even if you make a good model, but doctors are not able to use it, it will not be so useful. And to teach them, it's a bit complicated. Because, for example, models should be also put in nice, soft, and nice and easy to use. And this is a very important part. And we should orient not only on good model, let's say for ourselves, that I can open this model and change there some numbers and do something, but it should be really something with clickable buttons
Very friendly.
that's easy to implement. I think it's really a very important step. So I think it's very nice initiative. So you are designing now, right? This already.
I built, but my postdoc just finished, né? So I guess they will go on their own, because I was a postdoc, so I did my job, I had a fellowship, so I finished the postdoc, and I guess they will have to find more money, because I mean you need money. So my scholarship finished, but I'm still trying to go on if my own initiative, like at least trying to create a culture, to create a kind of trying to fight for the idea behind that you should not always make model. You should as well pay attention that your model will be used by somebody else. And most likely,
Yes.
this person has no idea about parametrization. They have no idea about biomathematics. So you should do something that's very easy and straightforward to use. When you drive a car, you have no idea how the car works, but you still drive a car. So
Yep.
maybe your model in the future, I believe that would be so easy, because sometimes it's complex, even for us to make parametrization, but you still can try, like to make a web application. I'm studying right now how to use deep learning with JavaScript for web development. And you already have very powerful ways to do this kind of simulation. Of course, I don't think that you'll be able to make like a very strong simulation using, in my case, you had to use like two servers, one server for head calculation, the other server for web application. But we already have very strong tools. And you have changed somehow the culture to think that there is always a client that's going to use your model. I don't know if you understood my point.
Yeah, yes. Yeah. I absolutely agree, but also be careful, because you talked about who will be responsible. And most probably doctor will say, "Oh, I did according to protocol, I clicked the buttons." And modeler will say, "Oh, my model actually is correct. It has all equations inside. All equations are right, but the result was wrong. Perhaps maybe it was some mistake. The doctor did not press the right button, for example." So it's
Yes, I know.
It's very important job, and very important that it's actually a big challenge, I think, because one thing is modeler, he really knows how everything is linked, and then you have to make it simple enough, but on another hand, to be able still to use everything from this model, all this
Yes,
flexibility. It's yeah.
but I think that of course there will be a kind of limitation, because as I was saying, sometimes it can be hard even for us to make parametrization, because if you make a parametrization, the model gets unstable. In the case of MATLAB, what they do, MATLAB create a kind of default set. The default set is optimized. So they say, if you want to change the default set, it's your business. So sometimes you make things like this, you create a model, it's already working, it's already okay. If you want to change the parametrization to make a kind of event behavior, be aware that this was not tested. So maybe I did that same question to a professor from Brazil, and she said something very nice. She said, you are going to need to train people. Maybe that's the point. You need to create the software and train someone to use the software. Maybe. But the point is that you should start to think about that, because when you build a model, in the case of, I was talking to you that I'm studying a technique called test-driven design. So the techniques try to change our mind, because instead of making the code, you think about the test. So you force yourself to think that your code can fail. So maybe start to think about how somebody else is going to use our models. You are going to start to think about how to make the best way possible to be simple enough. I mean, we talked about the discussion about the simplicity, Professor Hans and you and so on. You raised a very good question, because sometimes you cannot make the model simple. Maybe when you build a user-friendly interface, you have the same problem, because you cannot make it very easy to use. But anyway, you can try at least.
Yeah. Yes.
Did you like the content of this channel? So please subscribe to the channel. It's quite simple. You just have to hit subscribe, and you can decide which level of the notification you want. You may choose all the notification, which means that everything that I do, you receive a notification on your bell here on the upper corner, or you can choose no notification. I would strongly recommend you to subscribe, even if you don't wanna receive all the notifications. Just hit here, no notification. Or hit the one that you like the most. It's pretty important that you subscribe to the channel, so I can achieve a high number of subscribers, and people can as well understand that this channel has a nice content to offer, and YouTube will understand as well that it can make a nice divulgation of the channel. So please subscribe to the channel.